Thursday, it's Thursday. It's the most wonderful day of the year. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Thursday evening at the Bishop's house. All right, it's not my house. We've already established that. It's your house. You're letting me stay here. Wait, can you hear me? Can you hear me? I'm hearing music come through this now. This is bad. I'm hearing music. Can you guys hear me? Good evening. Good evening. No one's saying they can hear me yet. Yes, you can hear me. All right. Although I'm hearing Enya being played in this even as I'm talking. Let's hope that doesn't bother me. Yeah, you guys, can you hear Enya playing, by the way? Can you hear this? Someone just type in, yes, we can hear you, no, we can't hear, or yes, we can hear the music. And I don't know how to stop this, so this is gonna be interesting. Well, it's a good thing that I'm not listening to classic rock, because that would really be distracting. But this is the last thing I was listening to is an album by Enya. You know, it's very relaxing. Okay, good. Well, I'll continue to do it. I wish you guys could hear this. Hello there, Derek. Derek, you say, Bishop, that's great. Tomorrow we're gonna talk about how I can get do this without hearing music in my ear. He helps me with all this stuff. He works in our communications office. Okay, great. Well, hello everybody. Come on in. I didn't greet all of you, but I can see you. I see your names. Thank you. Not the music. Thank you. Can't hear Enya. Good. Okay. Excellent. All right. Well, it's Thursday afternoon and, it's Thursday evening anyway at 7:30 Central Time. It's getting a little cloudy out here in Pensacola and apparently the storm is coming. There's going to be some rain, but I don't think it's going to be that bad. And we heard that the schools in Escambia County here will start an hour later tomorrow. So we follow that as well. So our schools will start an hour later. I wish I would have grown up here. We never had school canceled, but it's already several times this year just because of rain and wind. I guess it's a bigger deal here with the bridges and everything. I don't know, but watch. That's a good way to make sure that it'll be a nice day tomorrow. You cancel school or you start a put in a delay or something, and then it's usually a beautiful morning here. So I'm just saying, yes, I made the call because that's what we do. We follow Escambia County for school in the morning so far. But anyway, oh, this is gonna be distracting. I just have a new song in my ear. It's Sail Away, Sail Away, Sail Away by Enya. I'm trying to ignore it while I just talk to you, but and it's singing in my ears right now. Wish you could hear this. Sail away, sail away, sail away. Okay, I'm gonna ignore that though. Because a professional speaker just learns how to, really focus and just block out anything in the background. So, Enya, I rebuke you. Not listening to you. Okay, so what I wanna share with you is just this, and I just thought of this because I was thinking earlier today, what am I gonna share with everyone. I've been privileged to be celebrate a lot of confirmations lately. In fact, I think it's been 7 in the last 4 days or 5 days. It's amazing. 5 Saturday, Sunday, Monday, 5 in those 3 days, and then 2 last night in Niceville. It's been a lot. And then this weekend, several more, along with the ordination of 4 new deacons on Saturday. So I'll be, and then Apalachicola, Mariana, Bluntstown. I am all over the southeastern part of our diocese. So I've been really focused on confirmations, on the homilies, on what I want to say to the young people and everything. And I don't talk about this too. I'm also really inspired just by talking to the young people, especially afterwards, and before the confirmation. I always like to talk to him and I say, are you guys excited? You're gonna receive the Holy Spirit. And granted, a lot of times they're not really, or they're nervous or they don't know what to say, so they're quiet. but I try to get them a little excited. And I say, all right, when your name is called, I really want to hear you say present, you know, and stand up proudly. And last night they did at both places. I was really pleased. They were coached and I coached them to really say present. So when their name was announced, they stood up and said present. And I remarked in my homilies how that's important, not just at that point, but all our life, to put ourselves in the presence of the Lord and just say, here I am. Use me, do with me whatever you wish. May your will be done. And that's the proper disposition that we ought to have, you know, in front of God. So, and then afterwards I talked to the young people who are confirmed, you know, taking pictures with them and at the reception and everything. And I just really, was really pleased. But when I got home, I realized that I was given a folder of, and I didn't even look at it, but red folder, confirmation. And in there are a bunch of letters from the young people asking to be confirmed or stating why they want to be confirmed. And I thought, this is what I want to share with you tonight. Just a few of these letters. I'm really pleased with the way the thought they put into it and their conviction and everything. I realize that, you know, a lot of times they're told you have to write a letter and here's what you should say. You should probably say, you know, why? What does confirmation mean to you? Who's your sponsor? Name one of the gifts that you're excited about as well as the name you've chosen. I get it. I know that, you know, it's not like they just have this idea to sit down and write this letter, but they're told to do it. But I really appreciate it. Many of them put a lot of thought into it, into their letters. So that's kind of what I want to share with you, just maybe a few of these letters, because I think, I hope you'll find them edifying as well. These are written by young people. They're about 15 years old, all of them. And here's just a sample of the letters that I get. And I get these a lot often, and I get to read them and pray with them. Here we go. Dear Bishop, confirmation will be my last sacrament of initiation, as you know. I like that. They say, as you know. But it is so much more than that. Confirmation is not about continuing, not only about continuing to build my faith, but also about strengthening my relationship with God. This is my chance to decide to fully enter the church consciously. When I was younger, I was baptized and got my first communion, but I didn't exactly have a choice. My parents mostly made those for me, and I followed. I'm super excited to be able to choose to further my faith, but it also adds more into my life. Take prayer, for example. Once I receive the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, I will have even more of an obligation to pray. It's going to be challenging, I admit, but the relationship I get with God and the fruits of that relationship will be worth it. I love that. So, very bold and good. Dear Bishop Bill. Actually, it says Bishop Walk. Very formal. I'm just going to cut here. I am grateful that I shall be blessed with the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, but the one I look forward to the most is fortitude. In a world that is trading faith and hope for convenience, I need to be courageous in standing firm and sharing my faith and spreading His gospel, for I cannot achieve this on my own. Your Excellency, I humbly ask for your blessing of confirmation that I may be brave, share His love, and so much more. Isn't that great? From a 15-year-old. Dear Bishop Walk, my name, it's not important. I'm 15 years old. Okay, great. My parents and grandmother have been instrumental in my Catholic faith. My grandmother has definitely helped me truly understand the love Jesus has for me, especially during some difficult and stressful times in life. She is beautiful, a beautiful, loyal servant of God. I aspire to have her faith, devotion, and trust in the Lord daily as I am confirmed. And then he says later on, my patron saint is Michael the Archangel. He is the patron saint of military and police forces. People pray to Saint Michael to gain the Archangel's protection in battle, strengthen our bodies and souls against the powers of evil, and grow in humility through relying on God and not ourselves. My parents selected my birth name as Michael because I was a 31-week preemie, battling for the strength to survive. I was blessed with prayers and a church congregation who supported my family during my 26-day stay in NICU, N-I-C-U. Isn't that neat? Here's another one. It doesn't say, dear Bishop Walk or anything. He says, people should always have a choice. When I was just a baby, my parents made my choice for me. They chose what religion I would be practicing for the next 15 years. This choice shaped the course of my life and how I would grow up. I wouldn't have met so many people and had so many unique experiences if they didn't make this choice. But next week, I'm ready to make my own choice. I want to be confirmed so I can choose to continue practicing the Catholic faith myself for the rest of my life. Just two more here. Hope you like these. I do. Dear Bishop Walk, I hope this letter finds you well. Isn't that great? I love that. I mean, it's kind of fun. Not many people say that anymore. I hope this letter finds you well, but here's someone who said this. I'm writing to share my strong desire to be confirmed in the Catholic Church. This decision means a lot to me, and I'm very proud to be taking part in this sacrament. Confirmation is a big step in my faith journey. It's about affirming my beliefs and welcoming the Holy Spirit into my life to help me live them out every day. Through confirmation, I will be able to fully step into the Catholic faith and deepen my relationship with God. I'm excited to take this step and be part of the church community in a deeper way. I am grateful for the support of my family, sponsor, and the parish. They've been with me on this journey, and I'm ready to continue growing in faith with them. And lastly, this one I like too, it's kind of just folksy, but great. Dear Bishop Walk, okay, I want to be confirmed because I want to deepen my relationship with Jesus. Here's why. I've been feeling this pull to get closer to Jesus. I want to make my faith stronger, and confirmation seems like the next step. It's like a way to show I'm serious about my relationship with Him. Also, I want to be a better Catholic. Confirmation is like saying, yep, I'm all in. I want to be part of the church community, learn more about what we believe, and live it out in my everyday life. I know it's not just about me. Confirmation is about God giving me extra help through the Holy Spirit. It's like getting a boost to be a better person and to help others more. I'm still learning, but I'm ready to take this step. I'd really appreciate your support and advice as I figure things out and get ready for confirmation. Thanks for listening. Sincerely, the name of the child, young adult, 15-year-old. Wow, this is why I love our faith. I love my vocation and my ministry as bishop. I love to be able to be the one to celebrate that sacrament with our young people. And we could be cynical and say, yeah, well, they're told to do that or whatever, but these are really sincere. And I talk to them, as I said, before and after confirmation, and I see them years later and they run up to me, you confirmed me, and tell me what they're doing and everything. It's really awesome. I think we need to hear things like this because, you know, we tend to get down on the world and maybe young people in the next generation, we wonder where's the hope for the future? Well, there's a lot of hope right there in all those people, the hundreds so far that I've confirmed this year. There's a lot of hope in our future, in our families, and in our church, and hopefully in you as well. I hope it inspires you to continue to inspire other people just by living your faith and helping each other to walk, you know, in the faith with the Lord through difficulties and challenges, as well as grace-filled days and joys as well. So there you go. So I may see you at another liturgy or event coming up. If you're here in the diocese, the best diocese in the world, Pensacola-Tallahassee, I'll be traveling around, like I said, the eastern part and the southeastern part of the diocese this weekend. Monsignor Reed is celebrating his 40th anniversary of priesthood. Tomorrow I'll be at that Mass at St. Rose of Lima. Looking forward to that. And ordaining four men to be permanent deacons here for our diocese on Saturday. That's going to be great. I'm sure there's other things going on Sunday, Monday. I'll be all over. But anyway, I look forward to seeing you when I can. But until then, know that you're in my prayers, and thank you for your prayers for me. Yeah, great. I think that's all I have for you. Anything from you over there? Just before I started, I just saw a big cockroach there, here in my little basement. Are you alive? Excuse me. Still alive. Down there. Can you see that down there? I don't know if it's a male or female. nor do I know how to tell. She, he is in distress. I'll have to put him, her out of his, her misery after this. And clean up the house, I guess. No, it just happens. I mean, I keep a clean house. There's nothing down here. There's no food or anything. I just get in here. Anyway, okay. But nothing from you. Do you have anything to say? Do you want to say anything? Nothing to say? Just wiggle your toes? Okay. Okay, everybody. I'm going to say a prayer for you, and then I'll let you be on your way for the night or the morning, wherever you are. All right, here goes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Lord our God, as we anticipate the coming of Pentecost, a renewal in the Holy Spirit, we ask you to pour forth your Spirit upon the face of the earth and into our hearts, so that we may be renewed, we may be strengthened in living our faith, we may be filled with your grace and your blessings, that we may realize the gifts that we have been given, the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, that they may take hold of us and we may use them to build up the kingdom of God. Bless all of us, especially those who are in need, stressed out, those who are worried or anxious or grieving tonight. Be their guide and shepherd and Lord and Savior. Bless us all, I pray, through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, everybody. God bless you. I will talk to you. I will hopefully see you next week. Yeah, God willing. See you next Thursday. All right. Bye, everybody.